There are seven chakras in our body, from Muladhara to Sahasrara, and Agya is the sixth chakra located right here. Agya is located at the Bhrumadhya, in between the two brows, where you can see my bindi, where we put our tilak when we do our puja. So Agya jo chakra hai, usse isliye third eye chakra bhi kehte hain. So third eye, as the name signifies, it activates our third eye. Hamari teesri netra ko Agya chakra jagrit karta hai. And when the third eye gets activated, we get enhanced power, enhanced perception. Our intuitive powers really increases. Our clairvoyant faculties increases. Our sixth sense becomes very active. We become more perceptive. We become more focused. We have amazing clarity of mind. We do amazing decision making. Now, the Agya chakra is a two-petal lotus, blue in color, located right here. And because it is located here, it is at the seat of pineal gland. Pineal gland is an endocrine gland. And pineal gland is the seat of Agya chakra. Plus, this whole region, including brain, eyes, nose and ears, are all controlled by Agya chakra. So when Agya chakra is not balanced, then it creates problem in this region. It creates problem in our thinking processes. It creates problem in our decision making. It creates problem in our neurological working. Plus, we can face problems with in terms of eyes, ears and nose. And it creates problem with depression and insomnia as well. So, जब आगे चक्र बैलेंस्ड होता है तो जैसा कि मैंने बताया, हमारे क्लेयरवॉयंट फैकल्टीज बहुत एक्टिवेटेड होते हैं, हमारी थिंकिंग पावर्स बहुत एक्टिवेटेड होती है. बट जब आज्ञा बैलेंस नहीं होता है, इन अ सिनेरियो व्हेन देयर इज टू मच ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ एनर्जी हैपनिंग इन आज्ञा, इट इज हाइपर एक्टिव, देन अ पर्सन टेंड्स टू ओवर थिंक. इट हैज अ डिजीज ऑफ थिंकिंग. ही इज टू मच इनटू थिंकिंग. ही इज टू मच इनटू कलेक्टिंग इंफॉर्मेशन. बट that leads to no results, that does not fructifies. On the other hand, if there is very less energy flowing in the Agya, then that person faces problem with decision making, that person faces problem with clarity of mind, he is not clear with his ideas, he is not clear with his vision, he is little depressed, he has problem with his sleep, he is not able to use his senses really well. So it is very important to balance our Agya. Now, there are a lot of ways to balance Agya. We can balance Agya through the sound energy. The beach mantra of Agya is Om. So when we focus on in the middle of the eyebrows over here, a two-petaled blue-colored lotus, and just visualize a blue color energy coming from the divine cosmos and getting projected on the Agya chakra. And as you're visualizing this, just chant Om. Then you will be able to balance Agya with the help of the color and the sound energy. But when you're chanting Om, just remember that in the chant, 2/3 time should be taken by O and 1/3 time should be taken by Ma. Then the chanting will be correct and holistic. Now, the element of Agya is Guru. Guru Tattva. Agya Guru Tattva se oth parot hai. It provides light energy to us. It has got that light element. And Guru kaun hai? Guru is that element which brings us from darkness to light. Ajnana timiranthasya jnananjan shalakya chakshurun militam yena tasmai shri guruve namaha. I bow down to the Guru who brings me from darkness to lightness because of the power of knowledge. सो गुरु हमें रास्ता दिखाते हैं, गुरु हमारे जीवन में प्रकाश लेके आते हैं, गुरु हमें मार्ग दिखाते हैं, ही इज आवर गाइड. सो योर आज्ञा विल बी बैलेंस्ड इफ यू सर्व द गुरु, इफ यू गिव द गुरु व्हाट वी आर सपोज टू गिव हिम. अगर हमारे जीवन में तीन ऋण होते हैं, मातृ ऋण, पितृ ऋण और गुरु ऋण, तो गुरु ऋण की तभी पूर्ति होती है जब हम गुरु को खुश कर सके. और गुरु कैसे खुश होते हैं? गुरु कुछ देने से खुश नहीं होते. गुरु डज नॉट नीड एनी मटेरियल रिक्वायरमेंट्स, ही डज नॉट हैव एनी. इफ ही हैज, ही कैन क्रिएट इट फॉर हिमसेल्फ. वॉट अ गुरु रियली वॉन्ट्स इज दैट यू फॉलो द पाथ दैट इज शोन बाय हिम. When we follow his guidance, when we follow the learnings that we have imbibed from him, then that is the true guru dakshina we can provide to our guru. That is the true guru dakshina. Otherwise, anything that we guru do for our guru is all the satisfaction of our ego. Our guru only gets satisfied when we follow his path, and he will be totally satisfied when we become ourselves an embodiment of his teachings. जब हम उनके मार्ग पर चलते चलते स्वयं अपने जीवन को गुरुमय बना लेते हैं, हमें देखकर गुरु के lessons अपने आप प्रदर्शित होने लग जाते हैं. We start reflecting the lessons of our guru through our lifestyle, through our words, through our action. Then that is what is true guru dakshina. And one follows this path, then he really activates his agya. Now, in order to activate agya, it is very important that you really make this area powerful. So this can become powerful by doing tratak. जब हम अपने दोनों नेत्रों से कोई भी एक पॉइंट पे फोकस करते हैं, और बेस्ट फोकस होगा अगर हम एक दीपक की ओर फोकस करें. जब हम एक पॉइंट पे फोकस करते हैं बिना ब्लिंकिंग किए, बिना अपने पलकों को झपकाए, हम जितनी देर तक त्राटक लगा सकेंगे हमारी आज्ञा उतनी सुदृढ़ और स्ट्रांग होती जाएगी. इनफैक्ट उगते सूर्य, बाल सूर्य पर भी जब हम त्राटक लगाते हैं तो वो बहुत अमेजिंग रिजल्ट्स हमें प्रोवाइड करता है. नाउ बिकॉज आज्ञा इज कनेक्टेड विद पीनियल ग्लैंड, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू स्टे अवे फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. Because the rays that come out from electronics, that leads to calcification of pineal gland. And the moment calcification happens, our pineal gland becomes less active. It becomes dormant. And then our agya also gets totally blocked. So in order to activate our agya, our pineal gland should be very, very active, and that can only happen if we stay away from these electronic rays. Minimize the usage of electronics as much as possible. And we can activate our agya through doing yogic kriyas. Any asana you do, do it with tratak. The more tratak you will do, the more your agya will get strengthened. Again, Bhramari is a very powerful pranayam to activate your agya. And the mudra for agya is just curl all your fingers and open your middle finger, touch the tip of your middle finger and put all your fingers curled like this and bring it near your chest. This is the mudra for agya. So when you apply this mudra and do your other yogic kriyas with tratak, perform your Brahmari pranayam, do the chanting of om, visualizing the agya chakra in middle of your eyebrows, you will be automatically able to activate your agya. And as I said, the element of agya is guru. So just follow the path of guru. The more you will do, your third eye will get activated, your sixth sense will get activated, and you will achieve the highest level of spirituality.